What's up, everybody? Jonathan here, and today we're back on Team Sardania Forestry Map, and I've got a couple of new trucks here to look at. This, first of all, let's look at this one. This is the Chevy Duramax four-wheel drive by FDR Logging. It does have a fuel thing in the back, so you can fill it up. You just gotta go to a gas station and fill it up. See, the 99 liters there is what the truck holds, and then at the bottom where it says 0 and 0%, that's where you have to fill up the rear end gas or fuel tank. And then this Ford F450 is by K-Man. You can find him on Facebook, but he just released this, I believe, yesterday, and it's a super nice dually truck. I was thinking it had the more aggressive tires. I'll not go with that option. Maybe I missed that. Oh, I know what it was. Yeah, there was an option in the... All right, hold on, let me fix that. We can't have that. This map, it's got a bunch of mud on it. We need some good tires. And let's see, go back to cars. 17 F450 wheel setup. I went with that one. Must be a standard. Yeah, okay, that's probably what it was. Let's go with that black horse. I kind of like that. In fact, well, let's go with the black horse and standard. But he does have a flatbed and a standard bed. Let's go with the standard. Oh, wait. Well, golly. I was thinking for some reason that you only get those two options. All right, there we go. Not sure what happened there, I guess. Anyway, you got standard wheels, and you got these Nokians, which I guess are the more aggressive off-road tires, which is what we're gonna need. And then we got the Chevy Duramax. Let's see here. I wonder if I can sell the right one. There we go. All right. Okay, so I'm gonna drive the FDR machine truck out here to the job site first, because I know this doesn't get dirty. He doesn't do dirt mods on any of his stuff. In fact, I'm going to go ahead and fill this thing up so we can have fuel for our vehicles out there. There we go, and it fills up pretty fast. And he does have sort of LED looking lights in the front, but no, you know, light bars or anything like that, no rear lights. That kind of sucks, but, you know, maybe somebody will take it and come out with a better version of it or something. Seems to have pretty good suspension. I don't understand really why FDR doesn't put the dirt mod on here. I mean, make the vehicles get dirty. It's not hard to do. Just I've seen it done. It's not that hard. And he was complaining that he didn't like the way the dirt mods looked. Well, you can control that and how you put it on there in Photoshop whenever you're making the, I guess you should call it the layer that the dirt goes on. How that looks. Maybe he just doesn't want to fool with it, but sure would be cool if it got dirty. It's always neat to me anyway. Maybe not to him or to some other people, but I like the dirt. I think it just adds that layer of realism. And so there's no difference between the inside and outside sound, it seems. Yeah, it's all about the same volume level. You know, I kind of like this truck. I may actually try to do the dirt myself. Like I said, I've seen it done. I've found some tutorials on YouTube, and it doesn't look that hard. I've got Photoshop, so I could probably do it. Let me see. I'm gonna park this truck up here somewhere. I need to get a few more of these trees cut. That or move some machinery. I got a bunch of stuff around here now. I'm just gonna park this truck on up here around this curve where all my extra equipment's at. Oh, and then we can do that. Oh, I forgot about that fuel tanker thing. Oh well. Alright, now for the K-Man. Well, this truck has a good sound to it. The only thing I'd say that I don't like about it, and it's just a minor little thing, he's got the, you know, the lights come on the front. I'm not sure what that click did. Then you got the lights that come on in the back and the LED bar in the front. And I think, was there fog lights in the front too? Yeah, so the fog lights in the front too come on in the high beams. So you really got some light when this thing is all lit up. The only thing I don't like about it, like I said, it's a minor little thing, but watch how fast this thing takes off. It's like almost immediately up to, you know, what was it? 20, 30 miles an hour. Alright, so watch the speedometer down in the bottom right when I hit the gas. It's like almost immediately up to 20 something miles an hour. I don't know. It's alright, I guess. You just gotta kind of be aware of it. Just especially whenever you're towing something or trying to make some maneuvers or something, you know. It takes off on you, it'll really mess you up. Alright, so what I was wanting to see was, does this thing get dirty? And my guess is that it probably does. This guy seems to do pretty good mods. Alright, but we'll find out shortly. Well, maybe I was wrong. Doesn't seem to be getting dirty. That's a bummer. So when you go splashing through those mud puddles, it really gets the truck dirty in a hurry, so. Did I see a collision issue? Oh wait, no, I guess I just bounced over the rock. Gosh, I wish this truck got dirty. This is a nice truck. It'd be a good one to do it with. Again, like I said, maybe I just need to go in there and do it myself. It's a super nice mod. I mean, look at all the lights. Look at the lights on the tail, on the tail lights. Super nice. Got a shiny chrome effect on the back there. You got the lights in the front with all the little LEDs. I mean, it's a super nice mod. I mean, it's very, very well done. But I think it's just missing that final touch of being, you know, being able to get dirty. Which I think I will try to do that myself. One of these days, whenever I can get around to it. Alright, well, I don't really remember where we were at last time. It looks like I know we started opening up the landing a bit. I think I need to try to get some more trees either cut or skidded up. Get some of these things out of the way, which I do have a new skidder, by the way. I forgot about that. I gotta get that before we can get started. Cause I decided to do away with the Caterpillar 555. I don't know, it's not quite a polished mod. It needs a bit of work, I think, and the the grapple seems kind of funny. I don't know, it's just, maybe it's just me. I'm so used to using the cable skidders now. But so anyway, what we're going to do is we're going to get the new John Deere 548H cable skidder. So let me find that. There it is. Now this machine, it's pretty fast. It's about, well, it says 20, but I think it goes faster than that. So I think I'm just gonna, well, I guess it is just 20. I'm just gonna drive it down there, because by the time I get a truck over here and get it loaded up and drive it back down there and maneuver through all the trees and the turns and the rocks and stuff, by the time I do all that, I probably could have just driven it down there anyway. So we're just gonna take off through the woods and go down the dirty, muddy roads. And this machine does get dirty, so you'll see it start to get a little dirty as we hit some mud holes. This thing probably takes the road better than the truck would. Oh gosh, well, I was trying to avoid. Deal with those rocks. There we go. The skidder is so wide, the tires are so wide, it's afraid it would have got hung up on them rocks. Barely fits on the bridge. That's starting to get a little dirty. That back area where the grapple and the winch is, that'll start to get pretty dirty. Alright, well this should make things a lot easier to get some trees skidded up. Thank you. the bat. Golly. Jeez. This thing gets so screwy sometimes. Well, at least it didn't cause too much damage. Yeah, I don't know. This, I think maybe it's just these trees. I haven't quite figured that out yet. But some, every once in a while, it does that. It's almost like the top of the tree is getting hung on something, which again is one of my biggest pet peeves with this game. Is the trees have no flexibility whatsoever. They're like steel rods. I think it's just touching something back there, and it's getting a little glitchy. But most of the time, see, like right now, it's not a problem. Sometimes I think the weight of the trees, too, is causing some problems. Well, we're still really kind of trying to get set up in this. Fog is still so thick. I've really got to open this up some more. I guess I got too much equipment in one little spot and not enough room to maneuver. So let's see if we can do something about that. If I can get unstuck from this tree. We'll take our, see, where what do I do with my, there, oh, there it is. I thought it was right around here somewhere. See if we can get this tree, well, it looks like there's two trees right here that's kind of blocking everything. Open this up, should help out a lot. Well, there's one facing the other way, too. Oh boy, what a mess. And we got a stump minefield over here again. Such a big skidder to get over these tall stumps. Nope. Next up is going to get those stumps out of there. How'd that tree get in the way? here too. I don't think I was really had it set to start cutting on that one yet though. Gotta make sure that your tree is in the right position before you start cutting. You know, sometimes it'll make a difference. This tree out of the way, I think we'll have everything kind of opened up right here in front of our machines. That should help quite a bit. While I'm at it, I'm gonna go ahead and try to get this one out of here too. Well, now I'm stuck. Dang stumps. The problem with this tree though is I gotta get it out of here perfectly straight, which means I probably need to move this tractor. See, there's just no flexibility on these trees. If the tip hangs up on another tree or a stump or something, you're just out of luck. Jeez, stop that. Let's see, let's get my, let's get the wood chipper back over there. I don't think we'll be using this tractor and this wood chip blower thingy. I want to say that I turned off. Yeah, I'm pretty sure I did. I turned off the sawdust mod. It's kind of neat, but it gets old after a while. You got to pick up all those wood chips, and I don't know. I just got tired of it. All right, now we gotta see if we can get this thing turned around. See, I did have the Pitts log trailer, that one over there, but seems like I had something. Well, for one thing, it doesn't get dirty. I know that's part of it. I don't remember why I stopped using that one though. Maybe I just never even really used it. I don't remember. There's just no good place to turn around. Go this far to get turned around. Can't even see what I'm doing. know what, come to think of it, I'm not really sure why I drove all the way up there and turned around. I needed to back in right here. Oh boy. When you get old, people, you start to forget stuff. See, how do I want to rearrange this truck? It seems like I've always had problems with the, or sometimes having it when it's straight on. So let me try kind of putting it at an angle. Try loading it like this. Trying to get some of these odd ones out of here so we don't have problems. I think the key with loading a good load is just got to be patient, take your time. Well, hopefully don't have the log slip out. So anyway, like I was saying, just gotta be patient and be careful and not try to overdo it. A lot of people I know, they like using the auto load, which to me, I don't know. It's, you know, if you don't want to play as realistic as possible, I guess it's fine. If you don't have dual joysticks, that makes a big difference. It's fine. But for me personally, I like loading it myself. It is frustrating at times, but like I said, I do have the dual joysticks, which makes it a lot easier. And to me, it's just more realistic. It you know, it makes you appreciate the people that do this for a living, because of course it's a lot different in real life. It actually works a lot better, I would assume, in real life than some of this stuff. Oh no. Ah, completely missed it. I think we can put maybe two or three more on, and we'll call that a load. I don't want to overload it too much. It's hard for me to know with this FDR grappa loader sometimes with these trees, you know, when's too much and when's not enough. Because on the FDR's trees, I've pretty much got it down to where I can know how many I can pick up in a grapple at one time. Just used it so much. Alright, that's a pretty good load right there. So let's take that on up to the sawmill. Well, maybe. Already. All right, well, we can fix that, I'm sure. I think the FDR trailer just kind of bottomed out on the terrain. Give it a little nudge. Another nudge. If that doesn't get it, we'll go up to the other side of the truck and give it a pull with the winch if it will. Come on, what's going on here? That might do it. I don't know. Maybe too heavy of a load for the winch to pull. I'm not going anywhere. Let's see what happens. Maybe too heavy of a load. must be on something. Uh-oh. Now, gosh. All right, now we'll just get it flipped back over. Always something. Maybe. Oh, no, there it went again. Okay, well, I think what I'm going to do is probably keep a winch hooked up until I can get the truck back under it. All these trees in here is killing me. I can't see what I'm doing. Well, that's wrong way. Okay, maybe now I can do it. Gotta get some of these trees cleared out of here. So, yeah, still hooked up. Okay, I think it should stay now. I should be able to make it if I can get going with some momentum and keep it going. like those again. Oh, okay, well. Maybe plan B. Alright, so maybe this truck just doesn't have enough power. Let's try the FDR truck. I know it's was built for this trailer, or the truck was built for something. Maybe it'll pull it up the hill. When in doubt, go with the truck that was built for the trailer. Alright, now we're going. I like the Sirius Mods Western Star truck because it gets dirty and it's a nice, super nice mod. But I guess sometimes you just gotta go with the truck that's built for the trailer. Alright, so let's get these logs unloaded, and that's about all the time we're gonna have for today. Had quite an adventure today. I don't normally roll the trailers. it's been a little while, I think, since I've done that. I think, in fact, the last one, if I remember correctly, was Appalachian Mountain version 1. I rolled a trailer going down the hill. I don't normally do that. Well, we got us a mess now. Wow. Oh boy. Yeah, I was trying to use this crane loader because I can't stand using the regular in-game crane because it's, I don't know, I just don't care for it. But, you know, now that I've got the Joy to Key profile for the crane loader, I may have to switch back to that. That machine's okay as long as you're slow. If you get to swinging too much, it throws them out of there like it just did. Start using this truck with this trailer. I was hoping to use the Western Star, but if it's going to do that, I don't know. I may give it one more try. So I think I was just trying to come up at a weird angle. Alright everybody, well, our adventure for today is over. We finally got our load of logs up there to the sawmill and got them sold. I'm going to get the skidder back down here to the job site so we can use it for other things. In fact, while I'm here, I'm going to grab this tree I just cut. Get it down back down there. But anyway, I hope you enjoyed this video, and we'll see you next time. We'll do some more loads of logs, hopefully, and maybe we can get something else going. I think, let's see, does this map have... No, I don't believe this map has any kind of lumber production, does it? Well, anyway, we'll get some more logs delivered, maybe get some wood chips up there too, and just continue on with this pretty cool map. This is Team Sardania Forestry. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.